This is also developing at this hour. Reaction to President Trump in a wide-ranging interview with Reuters, insisting he has the power to step in and run the Russia investigation himself if he wants to. The president saying, quote, I can go in and I could do whatever. I could run it if I want, but I decided to stay out. I'm totally allowed to be involved if I wanted to be. So far, I haven't chosen to be involved. I'll stay out, end quote. And the president did not rule out revoking the special counsel's security clearance in that interview. We're joined now by my first guest, counselor to the president, Kellyanne Conway. Great to see you today.
Thank you for having me, Harris.
Let's start with what the president means when he says that he could actually run the Russia investigation.
Well, the president and his team have been incredibly compliant and cooperative with the Mueller investigation. You have over 1 million documents produced, 33-some witnesses have gone and visited the Mueller investigation and testified under oath thusly. And so this is a president who also thinks that it completely ridicules the system of justice if we're not looking at the other side of this investigation. You had corrupt dealings all the way up the chain in the FBI. Many of them have lost their jobs now in security clearances. Andrew McCabe, obviously Peter Strzok, Lisa Page is gone, she left, Jim Comey, and the shenanigans he pulled in front of Congress and in his silly book. And the fact is that Peter Orr is still there. And we know that his wife, Nellie Orr, was paid by Fusion GPS, the research firm that started the ridiculous dossier. May I remind your audience, it's just a fancy French word for a load of crap, along with Christopher Steele.
Wow.
And yeah, because it is. And the president, there's a level of frustration and consternation that we're not looking at all sides of this equation. So the president also, look, the special counsel's under his purview, but he's been very cooperative, as have the other people who have been asked to speak with Mr. Mueller.
All right. You mentioned Bruce Orr and his wife, Nellie. He's on the list that the president has said he might strip away security clearances. Some criticism that it looks more political and retaliatory than something that protects the nation. I want to give you a chance to respond and then we'll move on.
So not everyone who's had a security clearance keeps them when they leave office, when they leave public service, I should say. Some do. But there are two primary reasons why somebody would is, number one, if you want to have a continuum, if that person wants to be helpful to the next administration. And Mr. Brennan has proven that he does not wish to be helpful to this administration. In fact, he's a virulent critic of this administration, this president's policies on cable TV, where he's now paid for his opinions. That is his right. But this is somebody whose claims were completely rebutted by an inspector general's report in 2014. This is someone who had a difficult time being truthful when brought before a congressional committee. And Chairman Burr put it best last week. Why, if Mr. Brennan, the former CIA director but current pundit on a cable news station, a lower rated one than yours, why would Mr. Brennan not have told the Senate Intelligence Committee what he thought with respect to Russia collusion and other matters? Why didn't he make it part of either his testimony, the information that he provided? Why does he wait to say that? So this isn't about silencing critics. This is about the fact that security clearances are privileges, they are not rights. And it's a professional courtesy to keep it extended to somebody who's no longer in public service and or somebody who wishes to be helpful to the successive administration. He's proven that he doesn't want to be helpful.
Well, it's certainly not about silencing, because we have heard more from John Brennan.
He said he's probably, that's right. He's